John Rogers, 3rd, 4th, and 5th graders. I picked out some books this week that are all a part of a series. And so I'm gonna do a book talk around these books. And what I love about series is that if you enjoy that first book, you kind of have that consistency with characters, with author style, and the similar plot points, which is always fun. So these three books I've picked out cover a range of abilities. So I'm starting with one of my easier books, and by easier I mean like more my 3rd, 4th grade level reading area. And then it progressively goes up. So the first one I want to recommend to you is this book series, The Sasquatch Escape, and it's the Imaginary Veterinary book series. So each of these titles changes. This is the one that stays the same. And the author, Suzanne Selfors. And so in this series, there's a character, Ben, who goes to visit his grandpa, and he doesn't want to go to visit his grandpa over the summer. And the grandpa has this cat, and one day the cat brings home this baby dragon. And he takes it to Dr. Ooh's veterinary clinic and soon finds out that this clinic is full, like takes care of all sorts of magical creatures. This is a fun, silly, it's got kind of a good page turner. And what's fun too is that there's drawings and facts to talk about actually Sasquatch. So if you want to learn more, it's got it interwoven in there. Okay, my next book series, and I actually could only find, my children have lost the first one, but this is the Origami Yoda. So this is actually not book one, but the Origami Yoda book series. This is super fun. So if you're into like Diary of a Wimpy Kid or any of those kind of books, this is like kind of a different step for you. So it follows kind of the Star Wars theme, but what happens is there's this boy who's in middle school, and he is making origamis. His name's Dwight, and he ultimately, in book one, he makes Origami Yoda. And his classmate, Tommy, notices it and begins to write the perspective of what happens in the adventures and kind of cataloging. It's silly, it's fun, it's based at school, and then each book brings in a new character. So book one is actually Origami Yoda, and then it goes on with these. And this one is actually recommended, I would say, like 3rd, 4th, 5th. And it's got a lot of fun drawings with it, and it kind of has that, again, like that Diary of a Wimpy Kid. Okay. The third one I picked out is more like my 4th, 5th, 6th grade level. And this is the Mysterious Benedict Society. And so this is great. This one is a cross between like Harry Potter meets Roald Dahl kind of adventure. So there's an orphan. This is a house for orphan kids, and there was a newspaper ad for brilliant kids to come and stay, and they're invited to do this top secret project once they've completed all these tasks to show just how smart they are. I think they're like 11 and 12 year olds. And through it, it's these gifted kids kind of realize that the adults around them might not be telling all the truth. And so through this book, they have to like solve mysteries, and it's like... there's a lot of twists and turns and different plot points, which is really fun. And the characters bond and grow together, and it's kind of like kids versus grown-ups fun. There are 4 books in this series, and there's also other additional books like puzzle books and stuff like that. Again, this one is like for my 4th, 5th, and 6th graders. So again, these are just a few. There's so many series. During these times at home, I recommend always trying a book one of a series, because if you like it, then you've got all these other books that you can read and fall back on. All right, John Rogers, keep reading. I'm thinking of you. Bye.